Hello friends, in this video I am going to talk about the 5 epic poems of each of the classical languages of India. There are total of 6 classical languages of India: Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam and Odia. In this order, these languages have been recognized as the classical languages of India. Classical language status itself is in itself a greatest narrator of what the languages literature is all about. Definitely each of these classical languages have a literary history of more than 1,000 years. Also, the rich literature presents us a vast amount of literature to study. Then how can we study this vast literature? Scholars have come up with a great idea of selecting few of the epic poems from these languages, calling them as Panchakavyas. Now, if a scholar wants to study the basics of epic poetry in each of these languages, if they study these 5 poems in detail, they'll have an overall idea of the language. That's what the scholars wanted to tell to the public. So they have selected these Panchakavyas in various classical languages. In my study and in my research, I have found out that the 5 epic poems are available for languages of Sanskrit, Telugu, Kannada and Tamil. I could not find the 5 epic poems for Odia and Malayalam, which are the other 2 classical languages in the list of classical languages of India. So if any of you know what is the list of these 5 epic poems in Odia or Malayalam, please let me know in the comments. Now moving on to the first classical language, that is Sanskritam. Sanskritam is considered as the oldest existing language of India. Also, it is such language which belongs to the Indo-Aryan language, has contributed in the form of vocabulary in all Indian languages. So any Indian language if we take, including Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, which these 4 belong to Dravidian language family and are not from the same family as Sanskritam. Sanskritam belongs to Indo-Aryan language family. Though there is a difference in grammar, sentence formation and other grammatical nuances and linguistic related nuances, but in terms of vocabulary, each of the 4 languages of South India have a heavy amount of vocabulary in different proportions. Tamil may have less, Telugu may have more, Malayalam may have almost like 60-70% of Sanskrit words into their Dravidian language roots. Though it is debatable, but it is agreed that all the 4 languages of South India have a heavy amount of Sanskrit words loaned into them. Sanskrit has these 5 epic poems listed as Raghuvamsham, Kumara Sambhavam, Megha Sandesham, or Naishadhiya Charitam, Kiratarjuniyam, Shishupalavadham. Next language is Telugu. Telugu is spoken in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, a few parts of Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Almost like if we go to rural side of Tamil Nadu, you will find that many people still speak a language that is more closer to classical Telugu language. Rather than Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, where Telugu is though official, most of it is highly influenced by the modern languages and has got very little about the classicalness of Telugu. So the 5 epic poems of Telugu are Shringara Naishadham, Manu Charitra, Parijata Paharanam, Vasu Charitra and Vijay Vilasamu. Next, coming to Kannada. Kannada is the official language in Karnataka state of India and has a very rich literary heritage. The 5 epic poems of Kannada are considered as Pampa Bharata, Adi Purana, Shanti Purana, Gada Yuddha and Karnataka Adambari. Lastly, Tamil. Tamil's 5 great epic poems are Shilappadigaram, Manimekhalai, Jeevaka Chintamani or Sevaka Chintamani, Valayapati, Kundalakeshi. Of these 5 epic poems, Valayapati and Kundalakeshi are unavailable. Manimekhalai is considered as an extension or extended poem of Shilappadigaram. Jivaka Chintamani in itself is a different poetry. Coming videos, I will try to cover brief stories of each of these poetry and some features of these poetry as well. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day.